Welcome all wonders in one sight, eternity shut in a span, summer in winter, day in night, heaven in earth, and God in man. Great little one whose all-embracing birth brings earth to heaven, stoops heaven to earth. We meet in the name of the living God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer. Amen. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the word of the angel to Joseph. You shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Therefore, let us seek the forgiveness of God through Jesus Christ, the Saviour of the world.
God, our Father, you sent your Son, full of grace and truth. Forgive our failure to receive him. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus, our Saviour, you were born in poverty and laid in a manger. Forgive our greed and rejection of your ways. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Spirit of love, your servant Mary responded joyfully to your call. Forgive the hardness of our hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God of his great love and mercy forgive us all our sin. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal God, who made this most holy night to shine with the brightness of your one true light, bring us who have known the revelation of that light on earth to see the radiance of your heavenly glory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, and glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks ahead of me because he was before me. From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known. This is the Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, O Christ. Never worry about the size of your Christmas tree, for in the eyes of children, they are all 30 feet tall. We are coming now to the very end of that season of waiting, watching, and hoping, that Advent time of expectation. Our Christmas tree isn't quite as tall as in other years. Our churches just can't be that busy. We can't physically meet together. Who would have expected, certainly not I or Reverend Anthony, that we would be recording a midnight mass of Holy Communion? All our expectations are having to change. But of course, that very first Christmas was not a Christmas that was expected. And it left many both amazed but also confounded. Each of those key characters in the story of the Nativity were themselves confounded. Think of Mary, confounded by that visit of the angel Gabriel, and how Joseph was confounded by Mary. And Mary and Joseph together by the innkeeper. And those wonderfully earthy and earth shepherds by that angelic host singing glory to God in the highest heaven and peace to his people on earth. And yes, also the lowly ox and ass, and possibly a camel too. By all that all too human commotion, as their peace and quiet was disturbed. And yes, let's not forget those wise men who expected to meet with a king but found a babe lying in a manger. And let's not forget the other king, Herod, whose expectations of worldly power and status were held to account by the divine coming of the Prince of Peace. These days of pandemic are confounding. So much has been turned upside down, and we have been left having to work out how it is we can live our faith through lockdown. But we know, don't we? We have discovered many wonderful and new ways to live out that faith, to reprioritize, to recalibrate what it means to be living in these strange but passing times. May your Christmas be one where you have the opportunity, however small your Christmas might be, to be confounded just by what God has done for each and every one of us in Christ, how he has in Christ lifted up the lowly, and brought glory upon each and every one of us. How he has given us a way to life in all its fullness through that babe lying in a manger. We will be praying for you wherever you are, that your Christmas may yet be joyful, that it will be blessed, and that in whatever way you will have enough amazement and maybe a little confounding to discover afresh and anew what the Christ child means for you. Amen. So now let us proclaim our faith in God Emmanuel. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Father, in this holy night, your Son, our Saviour, was born in human flesh. Renew your Church as the body of Christ. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, there was no room for your Son in the inn. Protect with your love those who have no home and all who live in poverty. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, Mary, in the pain of labour, brought your Son to birth. Hold in your hand those suffering from COVID or any other form of sickness, and all who are in pain or distress. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, your Christ came as a light shining in the darkness. Bring comfort in this time of pandemic and the isolation it brings to all who suffer in the sadness of our world. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, the angels sang, "Peace to God's people on earth." Strengthen those who work for peace and justice in all the world. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, shepherds in the field heard good tidings of joy. Give us grace to preach the gospel of Christ's redemption. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, strangers found the Holy Family and saw the baby lying in the manger. Bless our homes and all whom we love. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, heaven is come down to earth, and earth is raised to heaven. Hold in your hand all those who have passed through death in the hope of your coming kingdom. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, Christians the world over celebrate Christ's birth. Open our hearts that he may be born in us today. Holy God, hear our prayer. Father, in this holy night, angels and shepherds worshipped at the manger throne. Receive the worship we offer in fellowship with Mary, Joseph, and the saints, through him who is your Word made flesh, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and his name shall be called the Prince of Peace. We meet in the name of Christ and we share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
our Saviour Jesus Christ, who for love of a fallen race humbled himself, was born of the Virgin Mary by the power of your Spirit and lived as one of us. In the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused his light to shine in our hearts, to give knowledge of your glory in the face of Jesus Christ. In him we see our God made visible, and so are caught up in the love of the God we cannot see. Therefore, with all the angels of heaven, we lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name and sing a joyful hymn of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and the cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory.
Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people and gather us in your loving arms and bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Peter and St. Paul, St. James, St. Nicholas, St. Richard and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven.
Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever. Amen.
Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. God's holy gifts for God's holy family. Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God the Father.
So
Let us pray. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. So may the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Mary and Joseph, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and upon those you love, now and always. Amen.
Amen. Let us go in peace to make known the Word made flesh.
In the name of Christ.